Good morning, YouTubers, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. We are sewing away the last sail on the main mast. Try to true an even spacing on this, but that's like by eye. We finished up all the tie points on the middle sail on the main mast. This goes pretty quick. I just got to make sure I stay on top of the foot ladder down there on the back. Keep those, when the needle comes through, up above that foot ladder. Counterweight there to sort of hold that steady. This is supposedly the very bottom of this yard arm. We're sewing on here. We do want to check that again. You see that foot ladder there? Foot ropes tied together in the middle, and then on each end . This is a lot easier than threading those pulleys, blocking tackles. I should have enough thread here to finish this off. There's that fat rope sewn on the edge. Try to get just underneath that and through the material, up and around. I like to be in the material just a little bit. Came out of the thread. I put my zoom glasses on because I can't see. It's Mufasa hacking up a bone. see where that alligator clip is and move that over some. Get it out of my way. Try not to create any loop knots in the, like I did just then. Neighbor dog. Now we're getting close to where that foot rope is at. Tied off, we want to stay on top of it. And get one more here in the corner. Now, grab a old damn super glue. Got that glue on my thumb. Coming out. It looks like there's a hole in that tube. Stuff coming out everywhere. Coming out somewhere. Okay. Now, that looks okay. That's gonna go on up there. Camera. I don't know if we want to be, no, we don't want to be behind that, do we? Bottom one is, bottom part of the sail is high enough, but This one's just below that crow's nest. I got all these ropes coming in here above the crow's nest. That shows it up pretty high. So other than this one in the middle, I wonder if I should move that. A little bit of a dilemma there. It should be putz with it and see if I can figure out best place to mount. Got the camera sitting up in the ship and I'm doing that so I can try to get a shot of how I hook these bolo pins. You can see there I got it hooked around the bottom of two pins. Yeah, it just came out. This is really awkward. Try to hold that back. Get this to wrap around there. Get over on this side. I got to get around there at least two times before it'll sort of hold by itself. See, I got that little loop there, but it came off. Let me try these straight tweezers instead of the angled ones. Because I want to try to get to see how that's flipped in a loop there, and then I want to take that loop upside down. Put it over the bolo pin and then pull the slack out. Oops. Like that. So that was an upside down slip knot. And that's pretty much the way I've been doing a little hair there. Pretty much the way I've been doing all these bolo pin knots. Sometimes I'm able to cheat a little bit and of course it's really hard to get your hand in here. Not near as bad as the front end was. sometimes I'm able to cheat a little bit. You can see right here. What I mean by cheating, this is the rope for the other side. I gotta still tie off. But what I mean by cheating is I'll bring my rope down, go under, go back up all the way to where the block of tackle is, and then come back down and go under, come around, and do the upside down knot, glue it, and then cut the tail. Later on, we'll make some loops to hang on here that make it look like there's a bunch more rope instead of that tail being cut. Those loops we'll make ahead of time off the ship and then install them one at a time. But that back there is one of the simple upside down slip knots that we tie on top of the bolo pin after we have brought the rope down and grabbed the bottom of the pin. So we got this other one that comes from the, both of these ropes that are coming down are from these two blocks on this top sail we just installed. Through a pulley on each side. And we're using the bottom as our tie-off point. And the plans call for it to be out there on the side instead of in the middle. I guess it probably called for that because the middle's pretty full here now. The front and the back of that main mast. Pretty full, so now we got to tie this one off on this side over here. So we got to spin the ship around. I had the camera sitting on these two cannons in that board when we did that shot, so we'll pull that out of there and spin the ship around and tie this other one off the same way over on this side. Okay. So that's times two because there's one on each side. $486 down to the back. $486 One on both sides. So that takes care of these two. Down through a block. Down there to a tie-off point. 486, yeah, on the big bar. We don't have many on that little bar in the back yet. Tie it off here. Then we got the two tails on the bottom. And we got the lifters on the top. And they're tied off in the middle. Or no, they're tied off over here. We filmed that. And I think that's it for this sail. We got it to fit in there. So I think we're ready for the back rear mizzen mast. That takes care of that. Anything up here Yes. This is the middle mast. The tie points and the sail number. And this is the middle mast. 434. That's the ones we tied off on the side there on the camera. So it might be one on the back of this. Once we got that done, that's the top. And that tie off point 425 is done. Is here. I only think there's one of those. Nope. I was wrong. Starting to get all yellow. Where else? That was done with the dead eyes. And the rope ladder. That's all the dead eyes in the rope ladder. Thinking. That's got to be the rope ladder because it's a dotted line and they're showing it complete over here. So, there's one thing that I'm wondering about before I get to the rear mast. These upper crow nests here got little holes in these legs. I bet you when I ran these port lines from those dead eyes down there, that those were supposed to go through those holes. I bet you that's what was supposed to happen. And we just missed it. But we'd have to cut those and rerun them through the holes. That wouldn't be fun. If I could Dremel a little notch in there. I don't know. So I think we're going to go for the rear mast next. Because I don't see anything else I need to do to that middle mast. Some of these from the middle mast go over down near the rear, but keeping in mind that the lower sail is not in the kit. It's just supposed to be the mast or the yard arm up there. So we'll mount that first and get all that rigging done, and then we'll put sails on these two. These two sails left. We're getting there. Down to the nitty gritty now, baby. Okay, so what you just saw me tie on in speed up mode was this pulley here, tie off point up there, through that pulley, and down to the bullet pin. And then we got our tail out here on both sides. Tie off point there, goes through a pulley and down to the bullet pin. One on each side. And of course those are fun to get into. And that takes care of the all the stuff up in here is tied off and down. That takes care of all the rigging on this mast, the mezzanine mast, lower yard arm that doesn't have a sail. So I got the other two yard arms ready to go on. I got all the sails sewed onto them. So that one will go up in there. Then the smaller one will go on top. It's the smaller one and the big one. So that takes care of the rigging on the rear mezzanine mast lower yard arm. 949. That's going to go near the middle of the ship. See, there it is there, 949. I think these other ones are going to be higher. Yep, 992, 993, so that'll be the upper sails. And I actually ran out of my part polyester, part cotton thread, both the white and the tan. Use the whole spool. I got to get some more of that in order to finish up these other two sails. So that's this one here, 435, which is the bottom mezzanine mast. And that should go near the rear. This is the rear of the ship. 435. And then there's some more on that. There we go. 449. One on both sides, 449. That's going to go near the rear of the ship. 449. And I think on this page here, yes, the bottom one. The bottom yard arm is 426. And that should go to the rear. Here we go, 426. So we got two sails left. You see, this is the side view and top view of the deck. These drawings are really helpful when you're building the ship, but they're not technical. They're pictorial. See, there's a couple more I got to do back here I haven't done yet. Yeah, even on this drawing, the yard arm doesn't have a sail on it for the rear mezzanine masts. So we'll be doing these two sails next. That'll finish up the sails, which will feel good. Then I made up one of them. It's a little sloppy. I got this ready to hook on. That extra loop there is for hooking on. I might use this in the middle and make a bunch like this for the middle. Hook those on a bolo pin. And that'll help give the appearance that there's a bunch of slack rope there. Similar to what they got here, but they didn't do a very good job on these for slack rope. But we'll try to make it look better than that. Thanks for watching.